myth play. So it started out years ago studying Greek mythology and writing and performing a Greek myth play. And 3 years ago, as we adapted and changed, we started realizing that there are Norwegian myths and Egyptian myths, and there are myths all over the world. So the students have learned a lot. And then they take all of this, starting in about January, and they start writing and writing and revising and writing and revising and writing and revising. And then they start rehearsing. They were saying, oh, it's been 3.5 months that we've been doing this. And it hasn't. It has been 2 months and a week. But a lot of just energy and passion goes into this. And I know they're excited to share this with you. It's original. It's original every year. So please join me in welcoming our third grade for the 45th.
Mother Goddess Rhea, I wish for no glory. I just wish for a son.
Ah, kings and their sons. You'll get what you get and you won't get upset.
Time passes and the royal baby is born.
My king, I have the royal baby and it's a girl. Isn't she adorable? I'll name her Atalanta.
A girl? What did I do to deserve such a fate? Name whoever you want, but she is not staying here. Gone!
Please, no, I beg you.
Take her to the mountain. I don't even want to look at her.
Yes, sir, king, sir.
The guard listens to his royal highness and takes the baby. But instead of the mountainside, he puts her in a cave to protect her from the elements. Time passes and Atalanta is now a year old.
Wow. Tracks. I've been tracking this bear for a year now. Maybe today's my lucky day, I'll finally catch her.
Siri walks closer to the cave, hoping to hear bear sounds, but hears a scuffling sound instead.
What is that sound? I shall investigate.
He comes upon a child.
A baby girl? Oh my! This must be Baby Atalanta of Arcadia. Since this Baby Atalanta, the god must have chosen me to raise her. I'll take her back to my home and raise her. I shall teach her to hunt.
Siri is a great father and teacher to Atalanta, but as she grows, she has many ideas of going away from the forest. Father, she becomes a great hunter and is excellent with a bow and arrow.
Isn't it time for me to stretch my wings and get off this mountain?
You are safe here. Your safety is only guaranteed by the gods.
I can take care of myself.
No, honey. Only with the help of the gods you can take care of yourself. For they see that each of us will get what they deserve.
Well then, someday I will wear winter's crown of laurel because that's what I deserve.
In the palace, King Aias is demands to find out more about the great hunter from the woods.
I have heard many tales about this great hunter. Please summon him so I can meet him.
Fine, my lord. I will alert the town crier.
Hear ye, hear ye. King Aias summons the
the hunter to the palace. He would like to see this hunter in action.
Atalanta starts blushing and, oh no, Atalanta hears that the king would like to meet her and travels to his palace. When she gets to the palace, the king listens carefully to her stories.
Are you the one they call the pride of the woods of Arcadia?
I call myself Atalanta of Arcadia.
Do my ears deceive me? Did you say Atalanta?
Yes, I did. My mother gave me my name.
And what about your father?
His name is Siren.
And what about this? Siren Fellow?
He's the hunter who found me in the bear's den and is my father.
Well, it's time you met another father.
Bum, bum, bum!
What are you talking about?
Atalanta, I'm your true father. I was wrong to send you away because you're not a boy. Your mother cried so much. I was foolish. I know that now.
How could you? And what of my mother?
Your mother, the queen, has long since passed away, and now I am alone. I have no right to ask. But would you stay in the kingdom with me so I'm not alone?
I'm not sure. Fine, I will stay with you. Not because I want to, but because you need me.
More time passes and Atalanta's days are filled with hunting, winning races, and throwing the discus. She is unhappy that she cannot participate in the Olympics because she is a woman, so she finds other tournaments to compete. The king summons Atalanta to his throne because his patience has run out.
Atalanta, I demand you marry at once.
Nope. Yes. No way, no how.
Atalanta, I am not joking.
Fine, but only on one condition.
What is it?
We will have a race. Whoever can beat me in that race will have my hand in marriage.
That sounds about right.
But whoever loses will lose their head.
Wow, someone has a dark side.
Do we have a deal?
Deal. I will let the town crier and send messages and proclamations about the race. Town crier!
Hear ye, hear ye. The king's proclamation states that...
Where's the king's proclamation?
Ah, yes. The king's proclamation states that any man who can outdistance Princess Atalanta of Arcadia in a race shall win her hand in marriage. But for those who lose, the penalty shall be death.
Many suitors from around the world have come to Arcadia. The kingdom is pumped up with excitement because it's competition time.
I heard that you can meet anyone, man, woman, or beast.
Oh, I hope this isn't too hard.
This is gonna be a piece of cake. She's just a girl, after all.
Man, out.
I wouldn't be so short. I've cut off many hats, and I don't want to do it anymore.
Unfortunately, our three suitors have pinched.
Oh.
Why? dream?
This is not a dream. It is I, Aphrodite, the goddess of love, Melania, and I have a gift for you to help you win the race.
Aphrodite? What are you doing in my room? I don't need your help to win the race. I got this in the bag.
Really? I have seen Atalanta run. She's faster than Artemis and her arrows.
Maybe a little help couldn't hurt. Hint, hint.
Here, take these three golden apples. They'll help you win the race.
They are beautiful. But how shall I use them?
That is for you to figure out, my dear boy.
In the early morning, Melania stuffs the golden apples in a spoon. Don't know how he moves them. The spectators come to the race, screaming both Atalanta and Melania's names, cheering as they come to the starting step. Just before the race, Atalanta and Melania speak.
Draw from the race. Your sake as well as mine.
Remember, my dear, I've come to run with you, not away from you.
The trumpets blare and the race will soon commence. As the race begins, the two are neck and neck. Then Adelaide pulls ahead. Melania remembers to have those apples.
I forgot about the golden apples. I will throw the smallest one first.
Yes, I will. Wait, I just saw Melania pass me. Did he think I would let him win this easily?
Adelaide sprints ahead.
That girl can run. What if I throw the next apple? This one is bigger and better. I'm sure she will like it, and I can move ahead.
Melania throws the second apple.
For you, Atalanta. For you.
Ew, this one's bigger and better. Now I have two golden apples.
Melania is ahead, but just for now.
I must run faster and catch up to him. I know I can do it.
Atalanta forges ahead of Melania, showing her strength.
I'm still losing. But wait, I have one more apple. Maybe this will do the trick. I will throw it now.
As the apple is thrown, Atalanta hears a creepy voice in the wind saying,
"Take the apple, take it."
They're getting so heavy. Make haste, Atalanta. Make haste to win and pass Melania. Or do I want to win?
Now the two are at the final sprint of the race. The fans are cheering who will win. It looks like it will be Atalanta. But at the very last moment, Melania leans over her shoulder and touches the winning post and wins the race. Especially when the gods and goddesses are watching.
timing, the practice, the costumes. And thank you, families, for supporting your daughters.